Hi, Lumineers. Welcome to the Lighter Side Show. I'm your host, Jamie Butler, teaching you how to be an everyday medium. So what do we do at the Lighter Side Show? Is bring in incredible, beautiful people, and we allow them to share their wisdom and knowledge with you. And today we have that great guest. We have Master Marilag Mendoza with us. Ta-da! This is her.
Thank you.
We've already been sitting here a few minutes just kind of giggling about all the things we really do want to share with you. Master Marilag is a mother of three, married to Master Glenn Mendoza, MD. That was a big thing. You guys want to research, and we'll let you know where you can find Master Marilag, and we'll talk about what Master is and in what field that is. I know you already have a lot of questions, so thank you for thinking of them, and we are going to get to them. Now, Master Marilag owns her own cosmetic line. You do shampoos and lotions, and you can find all her health products at mhealthproducts.com. They're beautiful. In fact, you know, I had them over at my center before I even knew who you were.
Yes. Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes, some people had migrated in and kind of left some behind, and I kept looking at the beautiful, sleek bottles, and I was like, what is... Oh, I'm just going to use a little bit of this before they come back to get it. You know, I was like, oh, just smell it. It was so nice.
Why is that? The spray?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I took a picture of
it. It's a healing spray. Okay.
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
And it's like wonderful.
It. Yes.
But that's not all that you do. Mm-hmm. I first want to ask you, what does the term master mean?
Master, the name master was granted to us by Master Choa Kok Sui, the founder of modern pranic healing. It's someone who had reached a certain proficiency in healing. Not only in healing, because a lot of pranic healers are very good in healing, but it's also someone who had spread pranic healing, who had multiplied themselves. We train instructors to train pranic healers, and they multiply. So you can be a good healer, but if you have not taught and spread pranic healing in the different areas, then you're just a good healer. And as what's a good healer? What's a term master is, when I say proficiency healing, you produce miraculous results. Not just healing, wow, good, but seemingly impossible becomes possible.
I'm going to bite. What are some of the miraculous things that you have seen firsthand through your experiences?
So many. Okay, could be the emotional level, could be physical level, how people's lives get transformed. But some, like cancer patients, you know, like how cancer is so hard in the medical world.
Yes.
And sometimes you just do a few healings or a lot of healings, depends, and then you forget about them already. And then they come to you a year later, remember, I was the one you healed last year. Yes, I'm now cancer-free. Sometimes they would come to the full moon or whatever. Remember, I was your... Yes, that was 10 years ago. I don't remember, because every place you heal people. And they said, I have ovarian cancer, whatever. You healed me once, and then you told me what to do. You know, the Pac-Man, to eat all the cells, the cancer cells. And
I love that.
10 years ago.
Well, you just slightly mentioned the full moon, and when I was reading about you, I saw that you have very specific full moon, like healing sessions or healing gatherings.
Mm. Every month, we've been doing the Center for Pranic Healing, which is the nonprofit organization that was established in New York since 1994. We were some of the original servers or volunteer workers there. My husband and I, we had a leader then. We have been doing this every month with no fail since 1994. Every full moon, once a month, which is the highest energy of the month, there's a theme, like a zodiac sign for each for each month. This month, September, it was the Libra full moon, the next one in October. We just had a Virgo. So every month we harness the positive qualities of whatever the zodiac sign is. So if you do 12 months, you are a complete person.
That's fascinating. Are there other pranic healing centers besides yours? I think yours is located in New Jersey.
Yes, in Lyndhurst, New Jersey. Yes, I mean, the Center for Pranic Healing in New Jersey is in charge of the whole East Coast.
Is this the website where we can find you, the PranicHealingUSA.com?
Yes,
so
yes.
So our listeners, Lumineers, you can head over to PranicHealingUSA.com and you can find maybe the full body of work of where it is?
Well, this is where we train instructors in the different parts of the East Coast. Mm-hmm. So when they mature, they grow, they form their own healing center. Like here, you know, it's not a healing center per se, but there's a place where they meet regularly. They either do meditations, they either do full moon. In other areas, like Dr. Valerie in New Smyrna Beach, she has a physical center that she bought where pranic healers can always meet and gather and heal and meditate. Many centers along the East Coast, that's our territory, but mm-hmm. globally there's so many centers.
Like globally there's so many. We have many wonderful global Lumineers listening in and watching right now. Mm-hmm. So we definitely will show you, at least guide you to where you can find these places. Mm-hmm. I know that here at the Center for Love and Light, mm-hmm. beyond that wall, as I point behind the camera, is where we have Ursula Lentine comes, and every Tuesday night she does the Twin Hearts meditation. Mm-hmm. And one of my favorite things is coming to work on Wednesday morning.
What is Wednesday morning?
It's after Tuesday night, and Ursula doing her meditation. The office is...
Isn't
like
that wonderful?
Big.
Your office space, there's light, because every Tuesday night,
yes.
you spread the love and light. This is the place.
Love and light.
Love
this
and
is the
light.
Place.
It's perfect. So much love when you do meditation and Twin Hearts, and there's so much light. Master Choa said, if a lot of people, whether you gather in a home where there's three or more, there I will be, right? What Jesus said. But Master Choa said, if people just gather in groups, even small groups to bigger groups, in so many parts of the world, the whole Mother Earth will be a bright, beautiful place. It's a healing to Mother Earth. So even though it's just three of us in our house, mother, son, daughter, meditating, that's already bringing the light in that home. And imagine each home as well lit, the whole world.
Wow, a great visual in my mm-hmm. head. Yeah. Oh, I'd love to know more about pranic healing.
And then
I want to dive into kind of using some of these spiritual practices within business.
Ah.
Oh, yes. That is the nugget that I want to pick from you.
Okay.
But you come from pranic healing, and you just mentioned that it was more based on Mother Earth, and I wasn't aware of that.
Twin Hearts meditation is the staple meditation of pranic healers. When you take basic pranic healing, or you just visit like this meditation group of Ursula, you just want the meditation, you can come. So it's a service to Mother Earth. We live on Mother Earth, but we never pay rent.
It's bad.
I know.
We're parasites.
Living rent free. So it's our way of giving back to Mother Earth. By blessing Mother Earth, we visualize Mother Earth like the size of a small ball. By blessing it with love, with healing, with gratitude, Mother Earth is so happy.
She is very happy.
Very happy. Because right now there's so much fighting, wars, hatred. So when you do Twin Hearts, it kind of somehow neutralizes that anger energy and all this hatred energy happening. Imagine if there's no Twin Hearts, there's no people blessing Mother Earth. Just all this darkness of fighting and hatred. It's not a happy world.
It's not a happy world.
So, I mean, some places they gather 3,000 people, 5,000 people to meditate. Isn't that wonderful? And although we do full moon here in Atlanta, we do it in New Jersey, not only in our areas, but the West Coast, the Midwest, the whole world is meditating on the same days in different parts of the world. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
Yeah. Especially years ago, Master said about coming earth changes, all the earthquakes and everything. He was mentioning this in 1997. And it wasn't happening at the time, all the tsunamis that people see or experience. And his master, it's not happening. You know, the Y2K that we're scared of. It's not happening. And then he said, it doesn't mean it's canceled, it just means postponed. So do more Twin Hearts in groups. So somehow, the people meditating, that somehow saves Mother Earth from more destruction.
What is a good introduction into pranic healing? Is it the Twin Hearts meditation, or is it the basic course? I believe, don't you teach this online? Can people find you kind of worldwide online for the basics?
I don't teach online, but not good idea, I might. Thank you for the idea. I might teach basic online. Email me if you're interested.
We'll post her email. If she will let us, we will do this for you, yes.
Yeah, because, look, I was thinking about it, but I never really did it because there are many people in the outskirts, in the rural areas that have no access to the centers, or they don't have the means to travel, to leave the family or pay hotel. It's a great idea. Maybe I should do it.
We have a wonderful listener out in New Zealand. I believe you know who I'm talking about, Little Lumineer. And she has been such a great supporter. But she's, you know, if interested, it would be so wonderful to have that as an option.
Text me, email me, Facebook me if you want. If the demand is high, maybe I can create one.
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to create a stir. I want to be in the class with you guys.
Oh.
So okay, it's I'll an honor. Be first to register.
It's an honor. I'll let you know first.
I hope that the viewers or listeners, that you're able to tune in and just kind of get a sense of the feeling in the room. I mean, Master Marilag is a petite powerhouse. She's wearing a lovely bright pink fitted jacket. It matches her compassionate heart to no end. But there's a feeling that you get when you're sitting next to her. At least I speak for myself. My chest is open. My heart is open. My shoulders are dropped. I feel like I'm in the presence of someone who's going to care for me no matter what. And it's a great feeling, and I hope you're picking up on it too.
Listeners, do you want to feel energy? You want to get healed? I mean, if you want, I can do it at the end of the show.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, I can. So they can feel the energy.
Thank you so much for
offer. If they want, yeah.
Yes, I will speak for you. Yes, I'll go stand behind the camera.
Okay. Whoever are listening, you know, if they're willing, if they want it.
Thank you so much for that. That was very kind.
Okay.
Well, before we get into that, you know, we've talked about your level of understanding, your mastership in pranic healing. What pranic healing is, to me, if just new ears to it. Though I've heard, you know, some people around me who've been in it for some time talk about it, but I've never just dove in or gotten into the subject.
Mm-hmm.
But it sounds as if the way you're explaining it, it's kind of the energy of all, you know, from within to out and with the earth.
Okay. First, pranic came from the word prana, which means energy. That's why I said energy is everywhere. That's why I like it. We say in, out, everywhere, right?
Everywhere.
So pranic healing is a comprehensive system of energy healing that deals with the 11 major chakra system, in which the healer's role is to balance and harmonize the whole energy system, which is also in a happier and healthier person.
You say 11.
When you balance, you feel balanced.
Yes, you do. Mm-hmm. When you are balanced, and this is the concept of the Lighter Side show, we really want our listeners, I call them lumineers, people who shine light.
I like the name. I'll just give a side. My name is Illuminada. I'm illumined. When you said luminous, hello, yeah. Lumineers, I said, well, that's my name somehow. My full name is Illuminada Marilag. And lumineers, I said, thank you.
Yes!
I like your show.
Yes.
I'm one of your luminaries.
Honored. Thank you. That's great. Yeah, we all of us seem to be looking for a platform where people are talking about the mental, emotional, the physical, and the spiritual as being equivalent, mm-hmm. balanced, all mm-hmm. on the same page,
yes.
so that we can make choices from that place mm-hmm. and move forward with no regret, with mm-hmm. open hearts and acceptance,
mm-hmm.
even through the hard stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. Arguments and divorces, the things that we deem.
She's so common nowadays, okay?
Yes, and in business.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have a lot of lumineers out there who are entrepreneurs, who are great employees and managers, and they feel like they have to compartmentalize themselves and they can't bring their light to the job or to the work, whether it's because of the management that's there or in their entrepreneurship, they're not seen as an equal with somebody else who's more competitive or stabbing or money focused. And I see that you, oh yes, you have been able to really come and put all of these things into one basket, and they're harmonizing very well.
You want me to tell you this?
Oh my gosh. Come in close, everybody.
It's so easy. First take Pranic Healing.
First take Pranic Healing. Done. Noted. Basic online course coming when?
Yes. Soon. If you text me and there's a lot of demand, I'm willing to do it online. Why? Because you have an understanding of how energy works. Everything is energy. You can tap energy everywhere. Right?
Yes.
People are in business doing so much stuff, they're drained at the end of the day. They deal with people who are not so positive in life, they get sucked, suckered by a vampire. So how do you protect yourself from this? How do you preserve your energy? Even these so many things, you go home not drained but still up and ready to do work at home. Right?
Yes.
Where do you tap the energy? This is what we teach in basic Pranic Healing. It's called basic, but it's really not basic. There's a lot to learn.
It's incredible.
Yes. So once you have an understanding of how energy works, the number one thing I would advise is do meditation in twin hearts. What is meditation in twin hearts? It opens the heart. You said, I feel my heart open. When someone close to you has an open heart, it affects the hearts of other people.
It's true.
Yeah. So when you do twin hearts regularly, which is the key to opening the crown, so when these two are open, you have more connection. You have more intuition develop, so you get ideas, creative ideas come for your business, and you're nice to your employees or employers, because the heart is open. You cannot be cranky.
You can't be cranky when your heart is open.
Exactly. So you work in an environment where there's so much joy and harmony and love, and isn't it great to work in a company where there's so much love and support and everything? Instead of the competition, as you said.
Yes.
Because it only becomes competitive because of the nature. Me. When the heart is open, you. How can I serve? How can I give? How can I share? That's the function of the heart. Like Mother Teresa said, well-developed heart. That's why she cares for the sick, for the old, for the babies. She embraces and not think about dirt because of the heart. Right? So that's number one, twin hearts. Okay? We use any. Not only your heart is open, when your heart is open, which is the key to opening the crown, when that is huge, you are a big vessel for receiving energy from God, from whoever you believe in. When you are fed with that energy, you can feel that. We make you feel it in the basic Pranic Healing, how to feel the energy, how to be aware of the energy coming into you. When you're always constantly filled with that, because your vessel is big instead of this, you're just a constant channel of energy, which you can use for so many things. You can use that energy to heal people, to transform people. You can use that for your business. You know, you have more energy to do, to run errands. You're more creative. You're more expressive. It opens everything. Okay? Yes.
Question.
Yes.
I know I can hear, you know, the little voices in the back of my head wanting to know, because I get this from clients. They listen and they understand this vision and this concept and the concept of being in it and not desiring it as a goal, but actually being it. But there's a level of, how do I get it? How do I accept it?
Accept what? The twin hearts or the energy?
The energy moving through so that it does supply all that you need, so that you can heal, that you can be centered, you can be yourself, and any level or degree of tragedy, trauma, chaos.
How can I accept it? First, there has to be an understanding how it works. That's what we explain in basic Pranic Healing. Post down to taking the workshop. Or going to a center where they offer meditation twin hearts. The facilitator normally explains what happens in twin hearts and being aware of where the sources of energy is. So like, oh, it's coming from there. I'm aware. Okay, now what do I do with this energy, right?
Yeah.
It's not, one thing is accepting, say, not knowing how to accept. But if you explain to them, is there, it's constant. The sun is shining no matter what, right? It's always shining. It's up to you to close the curtains or to open the curtains. Let it in or close it. It's your choice.
Is this a age-centered meditation? Like, I mean, can we bring in the kids?
Cannot meditate because I'm old already? No. No. Okay.
Meditation. I have an 8-year-old daughter.
Yes, okay, this is what we did. Meditation in Twinas, if you look at the CD, we sell the CD. It says not for 16, only for 16 years old and higher.
Okay.
But I started Pranic Healing when my kids, my three boys, now my three men, when they were 6, 10, and 12. And, of course, this is too powerful for my kids. So what we did, we guided them. You know, the kids, they're like fidgety. They don't have the focus. 2 minutes only. Okay, say thank you, mommy. Thank you, daddy. Thank you for my clothes. Thank you for bringing to school, whatever. Okay, thank you, teacher. Thank you, classmate. Just the gratitude. And then later on, they can sit for 3 minutes. In the beginning, open the eyes. Later on, became 5 minutes. And then just the gratitude. Thank you for the beautiful bird. Thank you for the beautiful flowers. Thank you, mother. But that practice is not called twin hearts, but it expands the heart. Because the gratitude expands the heart. That carried on and when they were growing up. I feed them with McDonald's. Thank you, mom, for what? For McDonald's, in my mind. That's my role as a mom. Why would you say in my mind? And I realized the gratitude was inculcated from that small practice. Every little thing. Thank you, mom. Thank you, teacher. Thank you, class. Thank you, pet. Thank you. That's your 8-year-old start with that.
The gratitude.
Mm-hmm. And then when he's of age at 16, you do the full twin hearts.
That would be beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Very beneficial.
So in getting into accepting it and using all that is, all the mm-hmm. energy mm-hmm. from, and I like how you said from God or whomever you believe in. Mm-hmm. So it's not a
Pranic Healing believes and respects all religions, all philosophies. You can be a Pranic Healer if you're Jewish, Buddhist, Taoist, Christian, because there's oneness in God. There's only one God, different emanations. So you can call whoever you believe in.
I like that a lot.
So you can. It's so heart-opening when I go to one country where, let's say, there are Muslims, or one country where the religions are like majority of this, and then everybody's meditating as one. Whatever religion you are, it's like the unity. It's amazing. I go to Dubai, Dubai is like different countries, Muslim. You're teaching at 6 o'clock, they bow to Allah. We let them. We don't change them. I mean, I was Catholic. I was raised Catholic. Have so many questions about Catholic religion. Why do I have to confess to a priest? Why do I have, you know? But then, okay, it's boring. When I was a kid, I didn't understand. I was praying the rosary. But then when you understand the energetic aspect, why you're doing it in a mass, what happens when the priest raises the host, when you understand the meaning, what the energy aspect, then you have more appreciation for your religion. That's what Pranic Healing did to me, more understanding of why the rituals were done.
So can I ask a personal question?
Sure.
Do you still consider yourself a Catholic aligned with Catholicism?
Okay. That's a tricky question. I was raised Catholic. That's all I was exposed to, like Catholic, go to church. Mm-hmm. But then now, that knowing what I know now, we teach Buddhism revealed, about the inner teachings of Buddhism. We teach Hinduism, the inner teachings of Hinduism. Seeing how great Hinduism, how great Buddhism is, how great, what else? What else do we have? Christianity, Buddhism, Hinduism. Yeah, the religions. If you look at all this, even the Muslim, the teachings of Allah, they're all the same. So I would say I still practice the Catholic thing. I still invoke for Jesus. But I also call Buddha. I also call the other great teachers. And I call everybody. The angels, the saints.
It's good to have a big team.
Exactly. The bigger your team is, less work for you.
Well, I ask because, so funny. I ask because we get a lot of comments of, I was raised this way and I'm in conflict over it. And I understand everything being said and I believe in energy. Mm-hmm. And they're having a hard time loving the way they were raised and what their mm-hmm. belief system is and finding a way that it can fit them better as adults. So I was just curious kind of how you navigated that.
I came from your shoes. I mean, the same thing. Like, you asking me to invoke for Buddha when I'm Christian. My God before was Jesus and Mary. I mean, what's good in pranic healing, you're still free to call them. Like, one
complimentary.
There are eight masters in the world. And one master is Master Nona Castro. She was a nun for 20 years.
Yes.
A mother superior. She's still very Catholic. When she wakes up, she still does the rosary. She's still, Jesus is my God, whatever. But she does also invoke her. It doesn't, the beauty, as I said, with pranic healing, because you understand the energy aspect, I'm not limited to say, I'm not like, you cannot invoke for Jesus anymore. No, you're free to invoke who you believe in, and you can add. If you just say Jesus, that's fine. As long as you believe in somebody more powerful than you. Because Master Choa said, no belief in higher power, no pranic healing. Because you're not the healer. You are just a channel healing.
I tell my students, you're just the straw that it all comes through.
Exactly.
The Coke from McDonald's.
I'll give you one very example of that. Master Choa Kok Sui, when he was still in the body, very powerful healer. That's why I follow this line. There was in one of the World Pranic Healing Conventions in Jakarta, he said, who has a slight problem? And somebody who volunteered on stage is a doctor who had healed 30,000 cases pranic healing. He's a doctor. He believes there's more to traditional medicine than just that. So he found pranic healing. What he does in his clinic, he does the x-ray, the blood work and everything, blood pressure, and then he does pranic healing, and then does all this text. So he can see the effectivity of pranic healing. He had healed 30,000 patients, right? Yeah. But when he went on stage, it was in 1999, he said, what's your condition? He said, because of an accident, he damaged a nerve in the spine that made his foot paralyzed. So being a doctor, he healed so many patients already, he never even thought of healing himself because medically, that's irreversible. So he just gave in to the fact that it's paralyzed, right? So then Master Choa on stage on Friday night, because normally there are events on Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Okay, let's heal, you know, he healed. In my mind, I'm sorry, Master Choa. In my mind at that time, I was still skeptical. You know, I'm a pranic healer, but not, you know,
we're
it's
human.
Okay to be skeptical.
Yes, you're human. Human.
That means you have an intelligent mind, you have to analyze. That's the beauty in pranic healing. In basic pranic healing, the first thing we tell you, do not believe everything we tell you. You have to experiment, validate, and when you find it's true, then believe it. Okay? So we did it. And that's the feature I like in pranic healing. So in my mind, even 5 years later, in my mind, it's not going to be. I'm sorry. He hears me. It's not going to get that. Impossible. 26 years paralyzed. In my mind, okay.
26 years paralyzed?
Yeah, that thing.
Okay, I didn't realize it was that long.
That long.
Okay.
So that's why he never healed himself, because he thought it's irreversible medically. He's a doctor.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So in my mind, too, I'm married to a doctor, you know. In my mind, it's not going to happen. So that's Friday and Saturday, Sunday at the end of the event. So, okay. So Dr. Dango, do you want to come on stage, right? So he came. So tell the people. In my mind, I thought, oh, okay. And then, okay, tell them. He repeated what I told you. And how's your foot now? He was doing tap dancing. And of course, I would ask, wow. You're like, wow, Master Choa is good. Like, but what I admired about him, the humility, he was almost in tears. He said, with the help of God and the hierarchy of angels, everything is possible.
Everything.
is like he knows he's not the one who healed. Yeah. It's the hierarchy of helpers and angels, and with God, everything is possible. And he was almost in tears. He feels the blessings from. Say, oh, that removed my skepticism from then on. Oh, 26 years paralyzed, Friday night to Sunday night, topping. How can you explain that?
There's many things unexplained.
I know. That's what I mean by miracles in Pranic Healing, with the help of the hierarchy of invisible helpers.
Of all that is.
That's why no belief in higher power, no Pranic Healing.
You mentioned in Pranic Healing there were 11 chakras?
Yes.
So traditionally there are 7 in the physical body.
Right.
Where are the other ones coming from?
Oh, you want me to? Okay.
Yeah, listen. I set you up.
Quickly, crown. Forehead, where your forehead is.
All right.
Ajna, which is between the eyebrows. Throat. Heart. Front and back heart is one. Solar plexus, where all the emotions, negative emotions go. This is the positive, the love, giving, sharing, caring, sweetness. These are all the stress, fears, anger. So back is one, front and back solar plexus. So how many is that already? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? 7 is the spleen, wherever the spleen and the left rib cage behind that. Spleen, that's 6. We have the navel where the belly button is. Across the navel is what we call mengmen. It's what controls the kidneys and the blood pressure.
Mengmen?
Mengmen. Like chow men, low men. Yes. M-E-N-G and then main, long, low men. Chinese. If you're Chinese, would you know what I'm talking about? Mengmen. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The one behind is not considered as one as the label, unlike this and this. And then 10 is the sex chakra, which is where the pubic area is. And 12 is the basic chakra, which is on the spine and the coccyx. Okay, 11. And each chakra or power source or power plant takes care of certain areas of the body.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, Master Choa system is easy. Go to the main power plant, which will supply energy to that area. Powerhouse supply here. Powerhouse supplies the whole. It's very easy. So simple.
I've always found it interesting, especially in our American culture, we mm-hmm. talk a lot about our physical systems,
mm-hmm.
you know, respiratory, circulatory, mm-hmm. digestive, nervous, mm-hmm. skeletal. But we don't talk about an energetic system.
Yeah, because a lot of people don't know the energetic anatomy.
I like it, the energetic anatomy.
Mm-hmm. The chakras are your organs.
They are, yes. They feed you with all it is, right? They
feed the energy to the internal organs, the physical organs. That's why the organs are functioning nonstop. It's like this consciousness, this
So we had digressed and got on several different turns in the mm-hmm. road, which I thoroughly enjoyed. But kind of diving back into the kind of the spiritual energy within business, you know, those kind of morals or integrities, you talked about acceptance, the openness mm-hmm. to energy.
Once you do twin hearts, yes, accept the energy, save more energy. Okay, continue.
Were there other, like, basic?
Two in business. For a business to be successful, you need energy. Anywhere to be successful,
just
you
like
need
for
energy.
A person to be successful, they need energy.
Energy.
If you're seeing a business needing energy.
Yeah, there's a team, basketball team, 1-2. Whoever will win that game is the one with the most energy.
How are they getting that energy?
Okay, that's why you have to take basic Pranic Healing.
She's back. We're gonna get this class.
But once you have one thing is you already have. Some of you are entrepreneurs, you haven't started the business yet, you're thinking, some are already there, some are already successful here, right? Entrepreneurs mean you start your own business. But if you haven't started, even the choice of business name is important. There has to be energy just in the business name, okay? We teach you how to feel the energy, okay? Lumineer, whatever, ML. It's important that the energy that of the name that you choose has energy. Prosperity energy, success energy, right? Like in the name of a person, the name has vibration.
Yes.
Your name has vibration. it could be high or low. Same thing with business. That's one thing. And then once you already have a project in mind, a business in mind, you have to use energy. You say, how do you get the energy? When you do twin hearts, you use that energy, opens heart, opens this, it pours down to you. You're just a channel. Just bless it out to your business. Give energy to that business. And I talked about this event. When you visualize something, whatever your business is, whatever you want that direction to be, of course, successful, right? Of course, you want to have clients. You want to have buyers of your product, whatever your business is. So when you bless it, I want you to visualize with full completion where you want it to be with no doubt or fear. Because the doubt or fear will shrink the energy, will wash away the energy. So use the blessing, increase the energy, because again, it's energy. A successful business is a lot of energy. If I teach in basic how to feel the energy and you can scan your businesses that failed and businesses that succeed, you will see that the one that's successful has a lot of energy and the one that failed, no energy. So to start and to continue being successful, you need energy. One is flowing like this from them, you share it to the business. If you have employees, you have to bless your employees. If you have an employer, don't say, my boss sucks, he's like this. That complaint decreases the energy of the group. Okay? So bless them that they're more productive. Bless your boss that he's nice to you. Bless. The blessing is so important. It increases. Do twin hearts if possible. If you have a group, even for 3, 5, 9, if you have a big group of 2,000 employees, make everybody do twin hearts in the morning. Imagine a workspace, a workplace where everybody meditates. It's a very harmonious, loving environment where everybody will want to work and happy. How would you like to work happily in a place? Twin hearts, energies, again, energy. Instead of fighting, competing, criticizing, not successful. So many.
That's so beautiful. I love hearing that. At night when I go to bed, I clean the little energy of all the people I love.
I like it.
It's like a little...
I like it. In your own way or somehow.
In my own way. I do my children, my husband, my family, and then I do my employees.
And you have a happy family, you have a happy employee. See, in her own little way, intuitively, she's guided to clean it.
Right? And I wrap and I love them.
Thank you. You're projecting love. You want a harmony. Very good. Thank you. And you see, she said, and I can tell you're happy.
Yes, I enjoy being happy.
Exactly. When I met you, I like it. Because some people, they smile at you, but it's fake. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. But when I met her, the joy is from within. You can really see the joy emanating from within to outside. So that's a real joy, right?
Thank you. Yes.
Thank you for sharing this to me. That experience why you have the energy of joy.
It's so great to hear somebody else talk about doing it because it was just something I do in the privacy of my own bedroom before I go to bed.
Thank you. Not even a pranic healer yet, but she's already applying it. I'm gonna
be in that basic class.
Pranic healing is a way of life.
Like that.
Just a knowledge like that. Look, she's already, I said, you're a pranic healer already. She's already doing it in my private little bedroom every night. When you say way of life, you do it every day.
Yes, it's who
you
are. You
pray in the morning, you meditate, you bless people, you exude the kindness. Not like, okay, they said to be kind, but I cannot stand this person. You know, like, no, this is the time to exude that love, right?
Yes.
Some people cannot even do it. But eventually they become nicer and nicer.
I love that. Well, what about doing business and understanding money? There's a spiritual practice with money.
I was there. I was raised Catholic. In Catholic what? If it's something spiritual, you cannot charge. In Catholic teachings... If it's something spiritual, you're not supposed to charge money.
Yes, I have run across that more than a dozen times.
Yeah. And money is the root of all evil in Catholic.
That's what they teach? I was unaware of that.
Mm-hmm. Money is the root of all evil, but it's not true.
Do you
if you have money, you can do a lot. You can enjoy life. You can help people who are not as fortunate as you. But root of evil, it could be if you become a slave of money. But if you are the master of money, it would be good. So it's better, another thing in our, when I was young, it's better to give than to receive. And that's a program. So when people were paying me in the beginning, I didn't feel good receiving because it's better to give. How many of you there, viewers, have been giving, helping, and then when somebody pays you or gives you something, no, I don't want anything in return. Who came from that school? I was like that. And people paying me, no, all right. No. But again, there's no flow. It is in giving that we receive. So expect when you give, naturally, universe, nature, God will pave the way for you to receive 10 times or more. Yes. What I give. That's the law of karma. You give, whatever you give comes back to you 10 times. But if it's coming already, say, no, you stop the flow. It's like inhaling, exhaling.
How did you find the way to navigate through that, find the language for it, especially in the States? We have such a strong language around.
I know. We teach this. Money. We teach this prosperity workshop called Priya Shakti. Even though we teach it, I know the theory, but when I was telling the group, scan the prosperity energy of the person, the one giving, scan the energy of the receiver. Okay, receiver, don't receive. Say no. Oh my gosh, the prosperity energy of the giver shrunk and the receiver shrunk. Both of them shrunk. It did not benefit. So what I'm doing to whoever's giving me money or paying me for the healings, I'm not doing service to them. I'm not completing the healing process. Because they're giving so that the healing will be completed.
Yes.
It's a form of energy exchange for the healing they received. When I saw that, I said, I'm not allowing them to flourish, to be healed, to be prosperous. So that's one thing. Also, Master Choa in the olden times, 90-something, mid-90s, was healing a very severe case of herniated disc. Mm. She was paying Master Choa with some form of payment, and Master Choa, what are you doing? Okay, no, don't pay me, because the instructor, Master Choa takes care of all the instructors, and she was one of the instructors. So she had been suffering severely from so much pain, and then 45 minutes he was healing her, and it's not improving. Even though you're my instructor, you're really not receptive to my healing. Where's that coins, those gold coins? He has to accept it. So he accepted it and gave it to me, Marilag, for the center. You know, center is nonprofit, for the center. Okay, the idea is he accepted that. Once he accepted that, the healing, he absorbed the healing that he's been giving for 45 minutes. Because he was not receptive. The payment is a form of receptivity. Yes, I'm ready to receive because I gave you some energy.
And this is the same exchange that people find with goods and services, exactly. With client to lawyer, client to doctor, yes. Healing.
Why would people be willing to pay the doctor and not the healer?
Right. Because, like we mentioned before, the belief system is absolutely,
anything
if you
spiritual.
Can do this for free, then, okay. Or if you came in with it and you didn't have to go to school with it, then you
when
do
I
it
was
for free.
Somewhat starting, starting to accept payment, and I was teaching basic pranic healing. I was talking about how to help. There was a priest in my class. When I told him, you have to charge for the sake of his patients, you have to charge. You know what he told me? He was fighting within the class. If this is something spiritual, how come you charge? You know, like typical. He's a priest. Well, I told him this and all this is better for the exchange. Okay. At that time, I was charging $100 for healing. But not really, that's my charge, but I still refuse, but that's my tag. And then he came back 6 months later. I found out he got the teachings. He finally understood it. He's charging $200. Okay, I said, Master Marilyn, not only now I'm accepting healing, $200, I'm 6 months fully booked.
Right.
They value me more than free.
Yes.
And not only that, the patients get healed because the exchange of energy. I said, oh my gosh, my student, I'm the one who inspired him to charge. Now he's charging more than I do. I better raise my feet to 200. That's what made me bring up my feet from the student.
That's so funny. I just had an idea about these occasional people and lumineers. I know you've run into them before because we've reading your comments where you say you're doing your therapy, your hypnosis, your Reiki, your love, offering readings, energy, balancing, whatever it is. And then you get one person that comes to you and says, I need a discount. I can't pay what you're doing. And they chew at you. Whereas in general, the system is accepting you. And then you have this personality that comes and just, oh, well, you know, you're charging too much. And this is...
Once people come to me with cancer, with deafness, whatever. And in the center, we say by donation. By donation. I used to be active in the center when I wasn't so busy yet. I help healing whoever comes by donation. There was a person who was deaf. And every time he leaves the center, he could hear. You know how much he puts in the donation box? Pennies. I said, how much is your hearing worth for not hearing and then hearing? Pennies. Okay. People don't value what they got. They don't realize. But the point, he comes back every week because it's almost free. He just puts pennies and goes back to the same lifestyle. Right? So, okay, we have to stop this free healing by donation because they don't value. So if somebody comes to me with a severe case, how much is your life worth? How much do you think? How strong is your desire to live? How strong? What is that worth to you? If they value their life, I don't say pay me $1,000. I said, but don't give pennies. Don't give a dollar, right? You go to the hospital with all the operations and all this. You spend thousands and thousands on operation, and here I am fixing your energy. Don't devalue me just because you don't see the energy. In the doctor's office, they give you injection. They pay. Just injection.
Yes.
That's all. Okay. Here's a prescription. Go to... Right? That's the mentality of, but they're not exposed to the energy healing. They don't know they receive a lot.
Do you help people discover what their worth is for
the... Exactly. When they come for, let's say, they want to get rid of the cigarette addiction.
Okay.
How much do you desire to get rid of this addiction? I'm still enjoying it.
Well, they're not ready to let go of it then, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
If you're still enjoying it, come back when you're ready. Because I'm just going to be wasting my time.
Right.
But if they say, I'm ready, I'm trying everything, but I couldn't help myself, I'm ready, then one healing, done. Okay? But if they say, I'm not going to touch, they have to be ready. Okay. Now, for severe cases, I ask them, how much does it cost for you to be able to walk, to see, to hear, to be cancer-free? How much? What can you see in the future? How much do you desire to live? I have to ask them that. If they can see themselves living, doing something good for humanity and all this, you have to have a purpose. For God to extend your life, you have to do something great, not just go back to gambling and go...
I know, as I'm listening to you, you can hear all the ways that you're talking about healing, you know, to have a goal, to have a purpose, to have a mental, to have an acceptance, an emotional, to be ready to let go, you know, physically.
Exactly. And the hope.
It's the whole, all of it.
Hope that I will get well, and I get well, because a lot of people lose hope, really. Like the depressed people, super depressed, they lose hope. They don't even see beyond the day. There's no future. So I have to make them see the future. What can you do when you get well? What they don't. So that's when you do healing, remove this so they can see a better picture of themselves doing something worthwhile. And when they go there, it's wonderful to see the transformation. I'm super depressed, feeling hopeless with a purpose in life, like with cancer or whatever. And you see them live and become happy with family. It's a very rewarding.
Oh, it's very so rewarding. Fulfilling.
Yeah, very rewarding.
Just imagining it. And
yeah, very fulfilling. Mm. So, as I was explaining earlier in our holistic living, we just did. I said, what is fun to me? I don't go trekking once in a while. I don't go to the bar. So I don't. But the fun that I have in life is about seeing the students transform. Just from the basic level, they transform. It's like lighting the light bulb there.
It is. I tell my husband, I get so excited when I have an opportunity to teach or lecture or talk, because it's like waking up babies. Mm. It's so sweet. Get up, honey. Mm-hmm. Come on. And you see them starting to wake up as they're listening and their life comes on. And it's so
that's
exciting.
That's how it is. That's how it is when you teach.
Oh, I love it.
I'm not one. When I joined the healer certification in the 90s, 94, my goal was not to teach the world. I just want to heal my three boys. I just don't want to give them medication. I just want to heal them of fever and colds without Tylenol and all this. And then I did not enroll in teacher's training. My husband did. And so it's an honor to you because we've been doing service to the center. Why don't you join your husband? We don't charge you. I said, okay, so I joined maybe two sessions, three sessions. And then my teacher had to leave for India. Can you teach my scheduled class in New York? Me teach? No way. No, because I'm a healer. I want to be a healer for my kids only and not teach. So what? Okay. So my husband and I said, you're going to teach this section? I'm going to teach. So I don't have to.
This is how it came about, how you started teaching.
Yeah, because I asked to leave and there were 30 people registered in New York City. And you know, as a new teacher, having 30, that's overwhelming.
Yes, already. That's a lot of people.
My first Pranic Healing class. I said, what if they ask me this? What if they ask me? I said, what if? But as a training, in the training, say just invoke, just ask for help, that the right words will come to you. And everything will flow. Oh my gosh, I was so surprised when they asked, I know exactly what to say. And then I feel so good. Why? After the workshop, they were like, oh, thank you very much. I'm so happy. Really lighting up the souls of each one. It's like you woke them up from their sleep. Yeah. That was so rewarding. That's the start of my teaching career.
I love that.
No more what if. The confidence level when I saw the changes, that's it. Forget about what if.
Right, and then that can be taken into so many different avenues in our lives.
Fear is just here. The fear. But when you focus on the teachings, the message, you don't feel the fear.
Master Marilag is pointing to her head. She says the fear is in the head.
It's just in the
it's
head.
All stuck
you know
in the
when
head.
People are afraid of heights, they're afraid of falling, but they're still on the ground.
Get over it. No. You mentioned you just taught something. What was the class?
Holistic living.
Get
the
to
key
see you
to
in
happiness.
Atlanta often.
Yeah.
Holistic living,
the key to happiness.
Happiness.
I give them a wheel of life, which is the different areas of our life. To live a happy life, you need to put energy in every aspect of your life. To live a complete life, a holistic life.
And within Pranic Healing, we know you have the basic class and you have an advanced class, and then there's a prosperity class.
Oh, yeah.
There's this wellness. There's psychic protection.
Yeah.
There's so many other enhancements that come with it. You know, I just wanted the listeners to know that it's not just
healing. There's so many healing modalities, and I love all these different healing modalities. They're all powerful, they're all effective. But why I chose and stayed in Pranic Healing is because it has everything that a person needs to live a happy life. Okay, if you want the healing arm, we have a basic Pranic Healing, advanced, we use the colors, psychotherapy, where you deal with all the psycho-emotional, and then we have crystal healing. So crystal healing, instead of your hand getting dirty, use the crystal. That's the healing arm. And she said, I'm not really into healing. I just want my wife to heal me. I just want to be a patient. No problem. But if you want to be prosperous because you have a business, let the wife do the healing, and you have a business, you have the prosperity course. What are the energetic aspects you need to be prosperous, right? I told you, mind it. So we have the prosperity course. We call Kriya Shakti the science and art of materialization, materializing your dreams. We have also the Pranic Feng Shui. You know, we have the Chinese Feng Shui. I've read a lot of Chinese books. But with the scanning, you say, when you do this, look at the energy. Ooh, not good. When you look, what? It's a validated thing. Because I read so many Pranic Feng Shui, a lot of Feng Shui books. Mm-hmm. Some are like conflicting.
Yes, they are.
But when you validate with energy, I know this is the truth. Right? So I have, and we have spiritual business management. It's funny you're asking me, what are the tools that you can apply?
Yes, the tools.
Yeah. One is stress management, where you use the Twin Hearts meditation. And knowing the different race or different qualities of people. So you have a leader, you have an assistant, you have to have the different race in one, different qualities, different kinds of people. So you have all the scientific-minded, the money person, the boss, the love, the light.
Oh, that's perfect. So that anybody that's coming into the learning or the class can find their way.
Whatever you want. You want the business aspect there. If you look for a spiritual path, a spiritual, you know, something that will... I want oneness with the heart, so I want to be spiritual. But we have our Hatha Yoga, the yoga system, which for me is the one that made me stay, really, really stay, because I've been in different spiritual groups, I'm not saying the names, for 25 years. From 15 years old, my husband now is my boyfriend when I was 15. Yeah, I flirted young, I know. I was 15 in high school, third year high school, and he was fourth year high school. And together we navigated different groups. So I met Pranic Healing 40, which means 25 years of meditating, doing whatever we did. And when it came to Pranic Healing, my chakras were still small. Look at me.
Oh, it's such a sad face she's making.
No, really. I said, after 25 years. And my teacher, who was my teacher in basic, only 5 years in Pranic Healing and Arhatic Yoga, the spiritual arm. This big. I said, what? I said, maybe he was already a spiritual person to begin with. Okay, but when I scan his chakras, it's even smaller than mine. So I said, if he can do that, he served as an inspiration to me. Arhatic Yoga is a very fast way of increasing your chakras. What's the advantage of having big chakras? More energy, healing power increases. You can do more things. You can help people. So many advantages. That's Arhatic Yoga.
So much more energy you can run through your body without having like a side effect.
No, because
from it, because you can house the space.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
right.
It's like if you're just like this, and there's so much energy flowing, it's like a small pipe. Yeah, you have issues. Pour it to me, give it to me. I'm just kidding. I can handle. Yeah, it's really, you feel powerful, you feel, you know what I mean.
If you're just listening to this podcast, we're talking to Master Marilag, and we're kind of going over ins and outs, if you can imagine we're on a windy road, but mostly talking about the spiritual business practices, and we talked a lot about acceptance, energy, all that is, and a balance.
Mm-hmm.
There's a give, a receiver, and a giver,
mm-hmm.
and paying attention to this relationship. But overall, the number one take home, what I'm listening to,
yes.
is try Twin Hearts meditation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Start here.
Heals relationships, heals your business, heals home environment, gives light to your home, to your city, to the state, to Mother Earth.
It gratitude, yes, connection, unity.
Exactly.
It's wonderful.
Transforms people.
And we will post all the websites on how you can find Master Marilag, mm-hmm. especially at thepranichealingusa.com. Mm-hmm. And there's one if you're in the Southeast, and it is PranicHealingAtlanta.com, and it lists the pranic healers that we have here in mm-hmm. Atlanta.
Yes.
And I do believe it's mhealthpranic cosmeticproducts.com mm-hmm.
that from has a beauty line.
Yes, cosmetic shampoos and lotions, and it's all conscious product mm-hmm. for you vibrationally mm-hmm. to enhance yourself as well.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Doesn't just pay attention to all the physical systems, it's the energetic system that it's mm-hmm. helping.
Yes. Ah, you guys want healing? Forgot.
Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. Okay, close your eyes and make an intention what you want to be healed, what do you want to remove, and accept.
Do you
want to
be in front of the camera? You can be in front.
Am I not in front? Where is the front? This. Just close your eyes and be receptive. I mean, not charging you anything. Just giving you energy. Just accept, okay? So, whatever your intentions are, please remove my stress, remove my pain, whatever. Okay, just